Hi viewers, we are into the month of November, just 2 months away from the new year, and the solar eclipse and the lunar eclipse happening in September has actually prepared us for various other avenues which are coming ahead of us, and how we have to grab them is what the November guides us. Gemini, November for you guys. Now, on the 22nd, as the sun enters your 7th house, you enter a yearly peak of your love and social life. You'll have better love peaks in future too, but this is the peak for the present. So this November month is very good if you want to pay attention to your love and to your social life. Now, singles are dating more than usual and attending parties and gatherings. Those still in relationships are also attending more parties. So which means that if you're a single person and you're attending these parties, chances of you meeting your loved ones is very, very strong. But those of you guys who are already in a relationship could also be having a fun time together. So you still need to be more discriminating about all this, which means whatever you do, don't do it too much. You need to take care of your health, your mental and your physical health, and be discriminative with whom you are doing your social interactions. Now, choose quality over quantity. It's good that you've been focusing on your health. Normally, Geminis are known not to focus on the health, but it's very good that now is the time that you're focusing on your health, and your health actually needed attention from the 23rd of the last month. This will stand you in very good stead for 2017. Now, the situation is nowhere near severe as it was in September. The time period is much conducive to you, Geminis. September was a bad month for you, but October, November, December are actually very, very good for you. So always make sure that you get enough sleep and rest. If you're tired, just take a short nap. Leave everything, take that power sleep of yours, and you'll be rejuvenated very, very fast. Now, if a pre-existing condition does act up because of low energies, chances are that a good night's sleep and rest will relax you and you'll be bouncing back again to life. Now, the 24th, 25th, 29th and 30th are the most vulnerable days of this month for you. So take caution. Now, vulnerable in what sense? You'll say vulnerable that when you're meeting people, be cautious of what you're speaking. Don't be impulsive. Don't be impatient. And don't have preconceived notions. Okay, now this is when you actually also need more rest where your health is concerned. If you feel that you don't want to go for work, just pack your bags and take a holiday on the 24th, 25th, 29th and the 30th. Now, spiritual healing is especially becoming powerful for you after the 24th and the 25th. Continue to enhance your health in the ways mentioned in your yearly report. You remember I had told you all about reflexology? It's important that you get back to that yearly report of yours and get into your reflexology so that your energy levels are boosted again. Drive carefully on the 18th, 19th and the 30th. Now, communication glitches are more likely also. That means you may not be able to say things what you actually mean, and your words could be misinterpreted. So make sure that whatever you communicate in a very slow, steady, calm and a concise manner, because Mercury is going out of bounds from the 19th to 30th and Mercury is your lord. So when Mercury is going out of bounds, a person tends to be more glib, a person tends to be more impulsive and impatient. So you and probably family members too are outside your normal sphere. That means you're working outside your comfort zone during that period. We see this also with children and children figures. If you actually notice, some of the people behave in a very erratic manner, which is not their normal self. That is the time, instead of get angry with them, you should just give it a little bit of patience, space. So knowing fully well that the Mercury is out of bounds, so probably they are behaving that way, and after some time they would be back to their normal self. Now, this also suggests that in your spiritual life, you're moving out of your normal comfort zone and exploring the new spiritual territory. This is actually a laugh for the Geminis, because for them, spiritualism is according to their morals, according to their convictions, which is absolutely fine. But it's also important to actually know some of the spiritual facts and fundas. And you'll be surprised, in fact, you'll be surprising yourself that in the month of November, you'll be paying attention to what the other experienced people have to say. Now, whether inculcating that in your life or not is entirely your choice. Now, it also says that Venus has her solstice from November 13th to the 16th. She pauses in her movement and stays at the same exact latitude on those 4 days. And 4 days, now what happens when the Venus is in its solstice? The way Venus stands still, your love life also stands still. That doesn't mean it's finished. It just means that there are other things to attend to and you're probably not paying full attention on that, or probably you don't feel the need to pay full attention on that. So when the other person or your partner tends to question you, you can actually explain and be honest about it, that it's not that you're out of love, it's just that you feel very confident about the love that you don't require to explain and re-explain always. And remember, in relationships, trust and confidence is a very important part. Now, children and children figures also pause during that period. You'll see that the children are not interested in doing things what you are introducing them. So those 4 days, you should allow them to rest. Now, a pause in your spiritual life is also indicated. That means the spiritual inquisitiveness that had started in the end, in the start of the month, somewhere in between, it actually just pauses and you tend to lose interest. Okay, now let go of your spiritual goals and just allow the higher power to have its own way. Which basically means go with the flow. Just allow things to happen the way they are happening. On the 22nd, the planetary power begins to shift to the upper half of your horoscope. The dawn is breaking in your ear. The activities of the days are more important than the activities of the night, which means career takes importance over your love life. It is time to push forward to your outer objectives. Neptune, your career planet, starts moving forward on the 20th, which is a very, very good timing. There is more clarity in your thoughts and in your career matters. Thus, your efforts are more directed, more powerful, and your hard work is going to pay rich dividends for you in the month of November. For your honey days, your money days, your career days, and your stressful days, please check out my website. Thank you. Well, clients, it's very important to know that these monthly predictions are all very generic. They may comply with you, they may not comply with you, because you must understand that the entire personality is made up of the solar and the lunar placements of your personal horoscope. And you can take guidelines from what it is telling you or what you should be doing in the month ahead or what you can expect in the month ahead, but to get a more personalized readings for yourself, it's important that you look into your own chart, which we definitely prepare. And you could perhaps subscribe to my YouTube or even get onto my website and give us your details.